This is the home page of LinkedIn, or what I would see logging into the home page of LinkedIn. As I mentioned, LinkedIn has a reputation for being boring, or being this big graveyard of resumes. They've been trying to jazz it up by adding a news section. There is a news feed, this feed of status updates or posts on the homepage. A lot of it is activity, about people joining different groups or connecting with each other. You can also post a note, post a link. They actually still have a nice one-way integration with Twitter. It actually used to be two ways where you could both get everybody else's Twitter feed showing up here and reply back, but that business relationship is kind of falling apart. However, they will still let you post something here. If you have your Twitter account connected, you can check this box and it will automatically be posted to Twitter at the same time. That's not useful. Alright, we're here mostly to talk about search. Now, by default, you search on LinkedIn for people, but there are some other choices. You can search through updates, which are these status posts. You can search through jobs. You can search through the listings of companies. And you can search through answers. LinkedIn Answers is basically a Q&A forum. Can be a good place for you to go in and post questions that you'd like other people to answer, or for you to go in and answer questions where you can be the expert, or you can post a link to the great story that you wrote on whatever topic. There's search for your inbox, or search for groups. As you navigate around, the default will change. When you leave the people-oriented areas, the default will change to groups or to jobs or whatever. So that's how you navigate around. People is where we usually start. One of the sample topics I'm going to use is forensic accounting. So perhaps we have a story about financial mismanagement, fraud, theft. Locally, you know, we're looking for an expert to help us with that story. So, forensic accounting is basically detective work, sorting through finances. So, we see somebody that I am directly connected with, that he gave a lecture at SPJ. Send him a message. I can see some of his recent updates. So I can see his full profile. And he has chosen to share with his contacts an email address. Sometimes it will be you'll see a Yahoo address here. You may see a phone number. You may see their business email address. And I can also see who he's connected to. Now, LinkedIn does not display this until once we have a connection, I can explore his other connections. Somebody else viewing his profile for the first time who has been agreed to connect with cannot go rooting around in his connections. You can see that we have some connections in common, but there's also 500 plus people that he knows that I don't who might be additional useful sources. See that we also are on some of the same groups. And see that he's recommended some people. Maybe that's an interesting indicator of who he thinks is trustworthy and reputable. And down here we have a bunch of people who have recommended him. And then there's this longer list of groups. I am not currently a member of, but could decide to become a member. into this for a time. I'll see something. Includes a lot of the same details. Instead of showing me his connections, it shows me this thing that viewers of this profile also viewed. Sort of like Amazon's. People who looked at this product also looked at that product. So, I'm not connected to him yet. I want to ask for connection. I find this rather annoying. Some people who I've never worked with will check off colleague. And they will say that we were colleagues at X place. We weren't. Or I could claim that we were classmates in high school or college. But usually, with sources is we've done business together and stay in touch. If I say friend, it will probably prompt me to enter his email address. Other here definitely is going to prompt me to his email address. And I don't know. I'm not actually going to send it, but down here is where I would customize the message and say, "You were such a great help on that story the other day. Let's stay in touch." Now, maybe rather than asking him for connection, I just want to send him a message. Or, again, I could do let's get introduced to your mutual friend. In this case, we only have one in common, but we've had several that would be listed here. Or send the email. Now, I always have my phone number here. People can select what kind of contacts they want to receive. So some people will only say that they're only interested in getting back in touch. So we don't actually know each other. It's kind of rude for me to say that I'm contacting to get back in touch. But a lot of people will list this one, expertise request. They'd like to be known as an expert. And so type in a message saying, "I want your expertise." And down here you can see that there is a feedback score. If a lot of people were complaining that I was contacting them in an obnoxious way, the score would go down and eventually blinking to do something about it. Because I'm harassing people. Now, for forensic accounting, I just did general search. I could also, I'm trying to find people who work at a particular company, I could also just type that in up here. And we're going to find a lot of people who work at that company. If we go out to some of these later listings, we'll see people in here who don't actually work at Salesforce. Does Chris ever work at Salesforce? No. But somewhere on his profile he mentions that word. It's calling him right. Okay. There we are. So he mentions working with the application, it's just right clicker scan by company. So if you want a more targeted search, we want to go down into advanced. As a more advanced search, let's try searching through the advanced search form for FPL, Florida Power and Light. So we search here, and we'll find a bunch of people who indeed work at Florida Power and Light. But I didn't specify whether they had to be current employees. So if I go out to maybe the 10th screen of results, probably find some who used to work there but don't anymore. Person is self-employed currently, but has a history of working at FPL. Now, for some investigative stories, we might want to specifically speak out the former employees who can maybe talk more freely about certain things than current employees could. Or maybe the business is reaching some great milestone and we want to talk to past employees who can talk about the old days and how it got started, how things were at the beginning. Now we can look at past employees. That would also catch some current people who have a past title at that company but also have a current title. So we can make it past, not current. So we're particularly looking for alumni now of FPL. These folks should fall into that category. It's actually a friend of mine. I didn't know he worked at FPL, but I guess apparently he did a ways back. And more recently, he is a consultant on his own. Maybe what we really want to find is somebody who has experience in forensic accounting and is within our geographic area. Somebody who knows the laws in our state and who maybe has some knowledge, at least be familiar with the news story that we're asking them to comment on. Now these were all people who are in the Miami, Fort Lauderdale, or West Palm Beach areas. Well, let's narrow it further. How about CFO? Who has knowledge of the forensic accounting and is in our area. We've done some of those too. If the list is significantly different, spell it out. Now it looks like LinkedIn pretty much knows that CFO is the abbreviation for Chief Financial Officer. So that's good. Narrowing pretty much any of these searches by geography is useful. I mean, it's certainly useful in terms of job hunting. Is probably one of the reasons I had some assistance in the first place, but also in terms of finding somebody with a specialty who's in your area, or maybe the company that you're writing about is a national or international company, but if you're really trying to find employees for your area, who maybe are affected by the layoff. You could use this in reaction to breaking news events to try and find out a little bit more about an organization. Let's find people who, I was thinking of a news story the other day where three charter schools are all closed abruptly after the start of the school year. I'm searching within our area for people who have charter schools somewhere in the profile. And So here are some people that I might be able to tap out. Current or past connection. It includes the founder, Kirby, and some other people who either work here or have worked here. This is a more typical look of company page. They may be posting updates and see something about who's been changing jobs. And see who is within a couple of steps of my network is working at. And it's like some of my college alumni. Connections or introductions there. We can follow this company if it's one that we care about their updates. We can add that to our list and we'll get updates on the feed on the home. Groups. I mentioned groups are important. They do have a limit that you can join only 50 groups. It's another way of sort of forcing people to be selective and not be too spammy. They used to implement it. So I want to search for. What I'll sometimes do is join a group for the duration of a story on that topic. It's not something that's core to my beat, and drop it later on. But in the meantime, I can be investing some time there. This is my first degree contact there. Looks like the first couple of the list are actually ones that we have. So if I respect his opinion, that's maybe a good reason for getting into that group. Alright. And look at some of the groups that I actually am in. Looks like in Bernalis. So, there are general discussions going on in here. Somewhere in here there should be a post, me asking people to give me suggestions for this presentation. I didn't get too many responses to that. Alright, that's enough for LinkedIn. Facebook. Everybody and most of you know Facebook. Facebook currently I have a personal account, and I have some pages that I manage. Page looks kind of like a profile from the outside. Again, it does have a shared group of administrators. I can have multiple administrators. What do we get if we try and do search? We know pretty much what we get if we try and search by somebody's name. What if we try and search by friends that on Facebook? Well, first of all, it's recommending some pages. So it's like there's somebody who has a personal account and they put in the first name forensic and last name accounting, which is supposed to be against the rules, but the district only occasionally enforces those rules. Because a personal account is supposed to be for a person. So this doesn't look too promising just yet. Finding experts and might be good people behind who manage those pages. If I want to, if I really want to get to the advanced search, I'll click on see more results. And sometimes this will only come up with stuff from the web, not from Facebook. But for this one, we're getting some pretty good hits, some of the same stuff. But I can also look at people. So these are people. This is a personal account, even though it's labeled wrong. But here's somebody who worked at the Journal of Forensic Accounting. So that's where that's occurring in her profile. We also can look at just the pages. One important thing to note about the people, though, is that this does also have a way of us narrowing by location. So we can say Lauderdale, there is somebody who worked as a forensic accounting graduate student. Okay? Not a great list of results. Part of the issue is there are more people on Facebook, but they haven't necessarily put themselves into nice neat categories for us. Let's see. But we can also look at posts by our friends, if there are any, with the public posts mentioned. Right. Alright, so here's some. If I were to mention, do a search on charter schools, again, we just had three of them closed recently. And there's also some stuff related to charter schools and the news related to the strike in Chicago. So if I look at public posts, I see quite a few things people are talking about charter schools. Let's look at posts from my friends. Probably have more to do with local schools shutting down. In fact, I have a conversation with one of my friends there. It's a school board candidate, another politico. Somebody who runs a local blog. A bunch of people are talking about this stuff. And we look under people. And we find some people who work for some sort of charter school organization. This person worked at Broward County Public Schools. Right, so there's a number of people here who have some sort of connections to charter schools who also happen to be already in my network. Sure. We'll search for Mr. Canfield, who is one of the outreach journalist people on LinkedIn. I don't think we're Facebook friends. I bet she has a Facebook account. Let's see. Which one she is now. Might be her. I think this is, yeah, here she is. Senior Manager Corporate Communications at LinkedIn. Okay. So, for the results, people. care by region, as we tried before. We can also do education. We're trying to find somebody who went to a particular school, or mostly use in terms of people trying to find their college friends or whatever. Or by workplace. We'll try. Alright, see, that narrowed it down to this time. Here's my Twitter homepage. Search by keyword. This gives us general listing of posts mentioning charter schools. We can also look for people. I know it's labeled people. Some of these are actually institutional company or institution accounts. But I mean, that's the difference between profiles, really. Posting identities of some sort as opposed to tweets. So now I can sort through these. And we can see it's just a brief blurb that we have the context in each one. But we can either decide right away to follow them, or we can go take a closer look here. This is sort of a pop-up preview, or view the whole profile, decide to follow them, or decide to unfollow them. Again, charter schools. So how are we going to narrow this down to our area? Well, I showed you that there is sort of a keyword language that you can get to know. But to narrow down your results other than that, you can do it a step at a time using the advanced search form. So that's sort of hidden. You have to search for something, and just drop down to the advanced search screen. Here is where we can do near this place. Constructed the query terms for us. You can see it up here. It's near colon, Fort Lauderdale, using quotation marks. It's more than one word, and then within 50 miles, you can do Boolean expressions, using and or, so love or hate. Going back to things about people who have extreme experiences, extreme thoughts about things. Like love is winning out today. Not nice. And the or needs to be capitalized for that to work properly. Search for a hash. I use a lot. So this is a category of topics. Suppose we do again search for one just account. So we're going to pick up maybe some accounts that have forensic accounting in the name or in the profile. This is also linking to an article about forensic accounting. I guess that's why it's on top of the list. And also some other posts that mention something related to the topic. Now, right now we're looking at everything, but we could also narrow this down by just looking at people and pages that have something to do with kinds of accounting service on some pages, some businesses, or the subject is actually maybe a university program. And here is somebody who is promoting himself for his forensic accounting expertise. Some of the same search operators that you could use on Google will also work on Google Plus. Try this one. And then brings up any save as a heading or it's substituting in the bottom cards. This does not work for everything, however. For certain things, you actually are still a little bit better off going external to Google. So there doesn't seem to be a way of searching for people whose profiles show they live in a certain area built into Google Plus. But you can go out to Google, get a little Google, and put it on a screen like this. This is saying we're looking, searching the site Google Plus for the phrase charter school. We don't want it to be in the title because that would bring up businesses that have charter school in their name. But we want to find people who lived in the Miami area. And this will bring up a few of them. So. And this will bring up a few results. And this works because if we click through this person's page, the about section, see, this is how it's phrased. There's places lived, and then mine before, we're basically just keying in on that search text. You also see that this is not, however, huge list of people who are on Google Plus to match our keyword. And that's just reflecting the lower population that is there. If we searched for what we do, try the techie keyword, that you will get a longer list. Alright, so here's a somewhat longer list of profiles, still not huge, of people who work with the Java programming language who either live or have to live. I can also do location-based searches on Google Plus. Specifically, what they mean by that is a search of people who posted something from a mobile address. So I'm going to look for a broad topic, Obama. I can find posts from people in Miami saying something about Obama. And we'll see that each of these has some geographic information next to it. This was posted from a phone or a tablet or something, multiple devices.